Welcome to Snowflake MultiTeach 6.2. You'll see in this version we've completely redesigned the corner menu. It's even with a dark theme. And with this, we've also optimized the user interface so that the distance between the corner menu and all of the common things that you use is very, very short. Certain features have been added, such as the new timer function. And with timer, you can just specify the number of minutes and seconds. And once you have that, you can move it anywhere on your screen, and it turns green when you've completed the time. In addition, we've also added the ability to send feedback just in the bottom corner here. So when I click on send feedback, I can enter my email and I can add my feedback, and this goes directly to NUITEQ. All of the common functions that you used before, such as zones or the primary secondary, that is all the same as it was before. Now, for the first time, the corner menu now supports customization in the bottom right here. If you click on that cog, and it shows you an interface where you can add new apps onto your menu. And in addition, you can add in external applications just by typing in here, calculator. So you can add new apps, and you can also change the background. So if I wanted to have a treasure hunt theme, you could see I can quickly change the background. And now this gives the teacher a lot of flexibility in terms of which applications are available. I can push one button and I can reset to default. So let me load up the lessons app. We have now added rounds to the cards lesson type. I have a first round, which is just a really simple one. Just select the correct one and then great job, here's some more. And then as you get, there becomes more and more examples as you go along. So when I play this example, if I get the wrong one, it says try again. And if I get the correct one, it says, yeah, that's correct. And then, so that's really easy to begin with. But then the next round, oh, I've got a few more that I have to try. So then I have to try to find the correct ones. And then after that, then I have an example that has even more examples. So it allows you to kind of build up the difficulty as you go along, and it creates this kind of longer sequence for the cards activity. Inside the tags activity, and if I click on the tags, it used to be really difficult to read the tags or to see the position of tags if you have a white background. And so what we've done is we've added in the top right here the customized content button, which has a button that says tag colors. So if I click on tag colors, I can actually click on a color such as red, and I can say make all of them red. So it just makes them all easier to see. And if I want individual ones to be different colors, I can just tap on a different color, and then I can select the ones that should be different colors. So it gives you a couple different options. If I update the preview on the bottom, I can now hit play, and when I play the activity,
that relatively clean, warm, and moist air goes from the nasal cavity into the pharynx, or throat.
All of these activities now are color-coded with the colors that I had specified. If I go to the menu and I choose show answers, you'll see that I can see all the answers, and if I put the last one in, I get that feedback. If I click on this space physics lesson list, you'll see that I now have two buttons on the bottom. So we had the original playlist, which plays it in a linear sequence, and now we have the play randomize button as well. So if I click play randomized,
yes, then they can harness angular momentum to orient the spacecraft.
The sequence is now kind of randomized. It's not in the order that it was. As I can move between the different lessons, it gives me more flexibility in terms of how I play a list of lessons. So now when we go to edit a lesson, you'll find new functions for finding videos. So here in the lesson information tab, you, instead of just pasting a YouTube video, I can actually search for one directly using the browser. So here I can search for the physics of space battles, and I can choose this video. I can, again, set the start and the end time, and that will play at the beginning before my lesson starts. Also, you'll find that in the Community tab on the bottom right, if I click on that, you'll find that I now have standards that I can search for. So if I want to search for Newton's, I can find that there are particular lessons about force and gravitational force that I can add directly into my lesson. So that way, anybody who's using this standard can very easily find your lesson. Now, finally, when I hit submit in the bottom here, I can see this uploaded to the community. Now, if I go to Lessons Home on the left side of the screen, you can see there's this tab kind of up on the top here. If I choose a particular standard, Alabama, for example, you'll see my lesson appear. You can search by subject, you can search by grade, and you can also search by region as well. Snowflake MultiTeach now includes the ability to stream directly from your iPhone. I'm on the NUITEQ page. I can see the posts, and in addition, we have the ability to scale and zoom in. If I decide to rotate my screen, you'll see that it also shows that as well. So I have kind of everything visible directly from here. You can screen share directly from any PC or Mac. And of course, I can always use this in multiple zones as well. So if I want to split it into zone configuration, I can use two fingers and I can scroll and I can just see, say, just the top. So I do have a lot of flexibility in terms of how this is used. And that's my summary for Snowflake MultiTeach 6.2. Please check out the download link in the description.